Welcome back to STEM Camp. My name is Audra, and I'm one of your VEX Camp counselors, and I am so excited to be here with you today, where we are going to use the pieces in our VEX GO kit to build a claw. We are going to create a build that we can squeeze and use to grab different objects and move them around so we can play some really fun games. So before we get started on the building, let's talk about the things that we're going to need for today's session. You will need your VEX GO kit. If you haven't already taken apart your tall tower from the previous session, you're gonna need all of those pieces probably that you used in that tower. So you wanna make sure that you have all those pieces back in your kit and your kit is ready to go and build with. We're also going to need some items from around your house that we can use to test out our claw so that we can make some adaptations and figure out the best way that we can build a claw to move different things. So let's talk about what some of them could be. First off, we're going to need 5 differently shaped objects. Here I have some examples just to give you an idea, but you can really grab anything around your space. You can even use something like the pin tool or build some things out of your kit. So I have a small umbrella, I have a little ball, I have an empty soda can. We wanna make sure that if we're using anything with liquid, that it's always empty, so this way we don't spill and get stuff all over our go kit. I also have a little squishy toy, and I have a roll of tape. So we're going to need 5 differently shaped objects for testing our claw, and then at the end of our session, you are going to play the Speed Stacker Challenge. And for that game, you're going to need 10 empty disposable cups. We want to make sure that these are made of plastic or styrofoam or something that won't break, so no glass. So you can use styrofoam cups or plastic cups. You just want about 10 similarly sized empty disposable cups that we can use in a speed stacker challenge. All right, so now that we know the objects that we have, if you don't have any of them yet, you can pause the video here and make sure to go get those objects or take apart your tallest tower and put your pieces back. If you need to do that, you can pause the video, gather your materials, and come right back here. Just as a reminder, at any point during this video, you can pause it and rewind or replay it in order to see or hear something that we did in the video another time. All right, who's ready to get started building? I know I am. So I'm going to move my objects out of the way and I'm going to open up my build instructions. All right, so here I'm going to open up the build instructions. Now I'm going to have these opened up on our camp screen here. If you would like to also open up these build instructions on your own, you can do that using the link right above this video on the camp's page. So the very first thing I want to show you is what this claw is going to look like once it's all put together. So we're going to have a handle part of it, and we're going to have the top part of it here that's going to actually be the claw that's going to be movable so that way we can reach out and grab things. Okay, so now I think we're ready to build. I have both bins of my VEX GO kit here. I can see that all of my pieces are back together because I can see that there are no empty spaces in my kit. That's a great way to make sure that you are ready for a camp session. Take a look at your kit through that clear lid and check and make sure that all of your pieces are in place. Okay, and I've got my build instructions here, so you can follow along with me and we're going to build this whole claw together. So I'll have the build instructions open and I'll be building it here. So after each step, we're going to pause and compare and check that your build matches my build and the build that we see in the build instructions. Alrighty, are we ready for step 1? Here we go. Okay, it looks like for step 1, we are going to need 1 large white beam, and we're going to need 4 red pins. I'm just going to go ahead and take out the jewel case with all the pins because we know we're going to use a bunch of them. And we are going to need 4 of them. So now if we animate this step, we'll see exactly where those pins need to go. So I'm just going to tilt this a little bit to give us a really easy, clear view of those pins. I'm going to try to zoom in. Whoa! Too much, too little. There we go. Now it's nice and big. Okay, so we need 2 red pins in the top right corner of our white beam. 1 there and 1 there. And then 2 red pins, 1 hole up from the bottom when we're holding it this way. So we're going to put 1 in there and 1 in there. All right, so my piece matches the build instructions and your piece should match this as well. So let's move on to step 2. So in step 2, we are going to grab one of our dark gray large beams. So that would be these right here are the dark gray. If you look up a little higher, these are your regular gray ones. We want a dark gray large beam. And it looks like that is going to connect, yep, the end holes on that dark gray large beam right here are going to connect to these two pins. So if I'm holding it the same way, I want the last holes on my dark gray beam to connect to those red pins, and I'm gonna squeeze it and snap it together. All right, how are we doing so far? We're cooking with gas, here we go. All right, next up, we need a yellow beam and two more pins. See, that's why we took that pin case out. So we need a yellow beam and two pins. And when we animate that, we can see that in the center of the yellow beam, there's a little cluster of three holes. We wanna put pins in the outer two holes on either side of the center hole on our yellow beam, just like that, the same way that it is in our build instructions. Okay, now let's see where this yellow beam is going. It looks like it's going to connect on the bottom side of our gray beam. So let's animate it and find out. Yep, it looks like we need to do some counting here. So we need to make sure that it is in the one, two, three, in the third hole from the bottom. One, two, three, and it is on the bottom side. So when it's together, we can check here to make sure. We should see that the part of the yellow beam is on the same side as that white beam, and there's the black beam on top. Okay, if you got it on the wrong side, that's fine. You can just pop it off and put it back in place. All right, next step, we're gonna put this piece aside, and now we are going to grab a large black beam right over here and two red pins, and let's see where they're going. If I turn this a little bit, it's a bit easier to see. So here I am, I'm gonna grab my two pins, and it looks like they're just in the second hole from the top, one on either side, one on the right, one on the left. And there we go, that matches exactly. Okay, moving on to our next step. Okay, now we're gonna connect this black beam with the piece that we're building already. You can already probably guess which part of our adaptation claw this is going to be. So, okay, there we go. We need to connect these beams. I'm gonna turn it around just to double check. I'm gonna go back and play that one more time so that you can take a look and see. So we have these in the second two holes here, and they're gonna connect to the very bottom holes of our gray beam. So let's play that one more time. See how they come right up there, and they're gonna connect to the bottom holes of our gray beam. Now you'll notice there's a bit of an overlap here, and if we tilt our build instructions a little bit, we can see that the black beam basically goes right up against this yellow beam here, just like that. All right, moving right along. Now we just need two red pins, and let's see where those two red pins are gonna go. I have my two red pins here. Looks like we're gonna be using the gray beam in the center. We're going to attach two red pins on this gray beam, and we want them to go one up from the bottom if I hold it this way. So in the center row of holes, we're gonna count one up from the bottom. So there's one, and it's going in the second hole right there. Then we're gonna do the same thing in the center up at the top. We count one, and it goes in the second hole there. There we go. Okay, next step, we need one more dark gray large beam right here. And now it looks like that's probably gonna line up, yep, exactly with the other large gray beam. So if we look at this now, we wanna make sure that our new large gray beam exactly lines up with the other one. So we can make sure that our pins are in the same spot. And when it's connected, it should look like this. So now we have a white beam, we have a double gray beam, we've got a little yellow beam and a black beam sticking out. So you wanna make sure that yours looks just like mine does, and then we will move on to the next step. Okay. Next step. Now we need a pink beam and one pin. So let's grab a pink beam that's over here on this side, right up there, and one red pin. Now I want to always make sure that I'm holding my build the same way it looks in the build instructions, because that helps me to make sure that I'm putting things in the right place, right? It's just easier to see if we can compare it exactly. Okay, so I'm going to tilt my build instructions here and play that one more time for you. So it looks like we need to put our pin exactly in the hole right next to where these gray beams meet. So I'm going to stick it in, then I'm going to see what happens next. So our pin goes in, and then our pink beam is going to go right on top of it in the very last hole. So when we hold it up, it should kind of look like this, almost like a number 7. You'll notice this has a little bit of movement, giving you a little hint to how this is going to work. Okay, next up, we need 3 blue standoffs. Those are in a different one of our jewel cases here with the standoffs. We need 3 blue standoffs. So I'm gonna grab 1, 2, and 3. If any of your pieces fall out of your jewel cases while you're taking them out, that's okay. You can just put them back in. Sometimes I will use a little bowl or a cup, and I'll just pour everything from a jewel case into that to make it nice and easy to keep track of all of my pieces. You just want to make sure that they go back in your jewel kit when you're done with them. All right, so let's see where these blue standoffs are going. So first we want to put 1 in this open hole here on the bottom part of that yellow standoff, just like that. And then the other 2 are going to go in the 4th and 5th holes from the left on our white beam. So let's count 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So we want to put 1 in the 4th hole and 1 in the 5th hole, just like that. So you should have 3 empty holes on the left and 3 empty holes on the right. And that looks just like it does in our build instructions. Okay, next up, we need 3 more of those blue standoffs. Good thing I left that jewel case out. 1, 2, and 3. And now I need to pay attention again, remember, because it looks like we've turned our piece around here a little bit, right? Because now I can tell that that pink part is sticking out off of the other side. So now let's take a look at where these 3 blue standoffs are going to go. Okay. Again, we have 1 going on the other side of the yellow beam, so right here. And then we're going to have 1 in our black beam down here. And if I kind of move this and zoom in, it looks like it's in the middle row in the 3rd hole from the left. So 1, 2, 3, 3rd hole from the left in the middle row right there. 1, 2, 3, and there's our blue standoff. And then on the white end of things, we're going to go 1 hole away from our gray beam and put it right on the edge in that hole. And we can double check that by counting the holes in between these red pins. So we should have 1, 2, 3, 4 holes in between. And I have 1, 2, 3, 4 holes in between. So always make sure, we always want to make sure that there's a couple different ways to check each step as we go. It helps us to move a little more slowly and methodically as we're building, so we're more successful. All right, now we need 4 more red pins. Let's count them out. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And let's see where these red pins are going to go. They are going in the outer 4 corners of our large gray beam. All right, I'm gonna turn my piece. So we want them in the outer 4 corners. So 1 in the top left, 1 in the bottom left, 1 in the top right, and 1 in the bottom right. There we go. Okay, next up, we're going to put this to the side, and we are going to build a new part. So we need a large black beam, we need 1 red pin, and we're going to need a spacer. So I'm going to grab a spacer out of this jewel box right here. Remember, your spacers are the hard gray circles that look a little bit like a Cheerio. And now let's take a look at where this is going. So if I turn it around, it's a little bit easier to see. So it needs to go in the 3rd hole on the left-hand side. So if I hold my piece like this, I'm going to count on this top row or left row, 1, 2, 3. and the pin is going in that third hole, just like that. And then our spacer is going to go on top. And now, if we were to replay that step, we'll see exactly, yep, so now we can turn our piece around, and here we go. We've got our pin and our spacer, just like that. Okay, now we're going to attach this to our other piece that we have built here so far. Okay, so let's take a look at where this is going to attach. So it looks like, if I turn it, I can see these holes a bit better. Looks like I want to make sure that I have the two pins that are on the gray piece in the second two holes on my black beam. So that would be these two, holes right here. So if I line that up there, then my blue standoff should line up in the center hole down here that is third from the bottom. And we can see that if we tilt it and turn it a little bit. We can see that it is 1, 2, 3 holes up from the bottom. 1, 2, 3 holes up from the bottom. So at this point, both of your black beams should be even with one another, and your pink beam should be up against that spacer right there. So this is a good check to make sure that everything's in place with your black beams are even with one another, and your pink beam is up against that spacer right there, and it should have some movement still. Okay, are we ready for the next step? Here we go. All right, now we need a yellow angle beam. Ooh, I think we're starting to build the claw part. We're gonna take a yellow angle beam, and hey, there's those two pins that we put in right at the beginning. We are going to slide our yellow angle beam, and we're gonna point it this way, the same way that it is in our build instructions here. I'll tilt it a little bit just to make this easier for us. So we want to make sure that our yellow angle beam is connecting in the bottom two holes on, or the two holes here on our yellow angle beam, with it pointing away from the white beam. So we want it pointing away and sort of upwards if we were to turn it around, right? If we flip it around, we want it to point upwards and to the right. It's a nice easy way to see it. So let's go to our next step. Next step, we need another one of those yellow angle beams. Remember, they're up at the top of this kit, and two red pins. So these two are going to go in the outer two holes of our yellow angle beam, one up here and one down here. And we want to make sure that if we're holding it the same way, we're sticking them in from the bottom. So I'm going to put one in the bottom this way, and I'm going to put one in the bottom that way. So now I have my yellow angle beam, and my pins should be sticking out on the bottom side when it's facing in this direction. Okay, now we're gonna grab another pink beam, and we're going to connect our yellow angle beam. This top part of our yellow angle beam is going to connect to the end hole of our pink beam. So we're going to slide that right there and connect them. So now if I hold it up like this, it should match exactly what it looks like in that picture, almost like a little toucan with a really long nose, perhaps. And we have our next component. Okay, we're going to put that to the side. Now we need one yellow standoff and we need one spacer. So I'm going to open up this jewel box, get another spacer out. And I think we're just going to slide that standoff right into the center of the spacer. Yep. So we're going to take our yellow standoff and slide our spacer right on top. Okay. Now we're going to get another one of our yellow angle beams. And we're going to connect these right in the center hole of our yellow angle beam. So our spacer and standoff are going to stick right in there, just like that. It should look almost like maybe like a bee a little bit with its wings going, but it should look just like this, exactly the same as it does in our build instructions. All right, now we're gonna connect our last two pieces that we just built. So let's take a look at that. That went real fast. Let's take a look at what's happening. It looks like we wanna make sure that our yellow angle beams are connecting over two pitch segments. So you might notice on the side of all of your pieces, there's some little indentations here and there's little markings. Each of these is actually a unit of measure called a pitch. So we want to make sure that when we are putting these two pieces together, that we're connecting them with one pin, but so that they have two pitch markings overlapping. So let me make sure I have my pieces in the right orientation. So I need this piece with the spacer corner on the sort of on the top and the wings pointed down. And then I need my other piece facing just like this. And we're going to connect the red pin into the second hole here. So I'm going to put the red pin there and connect it into the second hole just like that. And now I can see that I have 1-2 pitch overlap of these two pieces together. And it looks just like it does in my build instructions, right? So I can see that my spacer sticks up a little bit on the side. I have my two pieces here together. There is some movement, that's okay. We just want to make sure that they're connected the right way. And I've got my pink beam pointing out. Okay. Next up, now, ooh, we need a red shaft. Let's go back to that same jewel case where we got our spacers from and pull out a red shaft. And let's see where that is going to go. That is going to go with the small side facing down right here in the second hole from the end of our white beam. So we're just going to stick that in just like that. And I'm going to leave that facing that way. See, I've got my shaft right in there. And since there's nothing kind of holding that in place, I'm just going to leave that sitting on my table for right now. Now we are going to slide this piece that we just built over that shaft. So let's take a look at how that works. Okay, did you see all those things come and line up there together? So let's look at this again to make sure we have things the way they are supposed to go. So it looks like this piece should make a bit of a zigzag, right? And my pink beam should be pointing in this direction. So now if we animate this again, we want to be sure that our shaft is going in the hole right next to that red beam right there. So I want to make sure that my shaft is going there, but we also need to pay attention to the position of this pink beam right here and make sure that it goes in between these two blue standoffs. So see here we have this big space of the two blue standoffs. We want our pink beam to go there and our yellow piece to go on the shaft directly next to that red beam. So now if we look at it all together, this is what we should see. And we have our pink beam coming through in between the blue standoffs, and I have my yellow beam connected with that shaft. All right, take a minute, make sure that yours looks just like that. If you need to pause the video and go back, you can. And we'll move on to our next step. Now, since there's nothing holding this on, I'm just gonna slide this over out of the way because I don't want anything to fall off so that I can do the next step. So for this step, we're gonna need a white large beam right here. We're gonna need two red pins and we're going to need a green beam. And it looks like we are going to stick the pins into the outer two holes on our green beam. And then let's see where that connects on this white beam. And then that's going to go on the white beam in the third and fifth hole from the right on the bottom. So I'm going to hold this up so that I can connect it on the bottom. So I want to go in the third and fifth hole. So 1, 2, 3, we'll get one side, then there'll be an empty hole and then the other, and then we will snap it together just like that. So now it should look just like this, where you have pins in the third and the fifth hole from the right. Okay, next up, we're getting there. Here we go. Now, we're gonna connect these and slide it down. So we just wanna make sure we know what all of those connection points are, right? So we have two pins here that are gonna be in the two holes from the right. So I'm gonna align that and make sure that everything else fits. My pink beam should still be sticking out. And directly next to that red pin should be my two blue standoffs, then one space and the shaft. So if we've got all that lined up, we can snap it in. So again, that's You should have empty holes on the very end of your white beam, then two pins, then next to this other red pin over here, two blue standoffs, and our shaft. Okay. Next up, our last one of our yellow angle beams. We're going to hold it just like this, and we're going to stick two pins in that from the bottom. So we want to hold it like this and put it in the first and the third right there. One here. But we're sticking them in from the bottom so that we match what we see in our build instructions. And then we're going to connect that to our bottom pink beam that's sticking out down here. Not this one up here, our bottom one down here. So now if we look to see, we turn that around a little bit, we can see that there should be one hole. And then we're going in the second hole with the top part. And if we get that, we should get the rest of it together. So now there should be two empty holes on the bottom of the pink beam, and then our yellow beam is in place. Okay. Now, did you see what happened there? Our whole thing flipped over. So now we have something holding this together. So we are going to flip our whole structure over, and we're going to grab two red pins. And we are going to stick them in one on this last hole. Whoop, let me move this over so you can see it. We're going to stick one red pin in the last hole here of our pink beam up at the top. And then we're going to stick one more pin down in the last hole of this yellow beam that we just added. Okay. Next. Ooh, this is a new piece we haven't used yet. So we're going to go into the same box that held your rubber bands, and we are going to pull out a string. And you'll see that these strings have little holes on the end of them. And guess what? These little holes fit over pins. So what we're going to do here is we're going to connect one end of the string to the pin that we just put in, and the other end of the string to the other pin that we just put in. Just like that. Now you can see how they're connected. Oh, you're getting a little preview here of how this is going to work. All right, now we're going to turn it over again. Flip it back over. Now we're going to go back to that same box and take out a rubber band. Here we go. You also have strings with little white ends on them. You want to make sure that in that step you use the string with the black ends so that it's not too long and it makes our adaptation claw work right. Now we're going to need a rubber band. So we are going to hook that rubber band over this bottom blue standoff. Remember, we flipped our tool around, so we want to make sure that it looks exactly the same, right? This rubber band should be going in between these two pink standoffs and on the same side as the string. And then we're going to stretch the rubber band and not snap it. We're going to stretch it and put it over that spacer and standoff up at the top. So your rubber band should stretch from this blue standoff all the way up and over around to that standoff right there. All right, now we need two more red pins. And we are going to stick them into the center gray beam here directly next to this black beam. So let me hold that up so you can see it a little bit better. There's two holes right in between the blue standoffs, and we're gonna go right there. So let me get one in there and a second right there. Okay, now we need one yellow beam. And this is going to connect four holes over these four pins and standoff spaces, just like that. So that goes all the way across. That'll make sure our rubber band stays in place right there. Okay, now we're ready to build the last part of our claw. So we're gonna need one of our red angle beams from the top of our plastic bin. We're gonna hold it like this and add two red pins to these top two holes right here. One and two. And then we're going to attach that to the yellow angle beams here underneath to make a claw. This is the first part of our claw, so we want to make sure that it's hooking down just like that. I bet you can guess what we're going to do on the other side. We're going to grab that other red angle beam. We're going to turn it in the other direction. And we are going to attach two red pins underneath in the same way we just did. So in the top holes, underneath, and then we are going to add this right here to these two remaining holes on our yellow beam, just like that. And guess what? We just built our very own adaptation claw. Oh my goodness. Oh my gosh, we just built it. Okay, before I get too excited, I'm gonna make sure I put these jewel cases away because I don't wanna lose all of my pins on the floor. I'm gonna close up my kit and I'm gonna get ready to test out my claw. All right, let me slide that over. Now, how do you think you use this? I bet you have a pretty good guess, right? So this part down here is our little trigger. So if we pull that, what happens up at the top? The two sides of our claw come together. So basically, we can walk around and grab stuff all over the place. These are a super fun toy and we are gonna have a lot of fun with them. But you should probably also know that there are people that use these to help them grab and move things all over the place when they have limited mobility. So we're gonna think about the ways that we can make this claw even better than it already is. But first, we should probably figure out what kinds of stuff our claw can move. So remember those five objects we had before? Let me move my kit out of the way here. Well, now we're gonna set up those five objects. I've got a roll of tape. I've got a little squishy toy. I have my soda can. I have my little ball. And I have my umbrella. Hey, ball, stay in place. Okay, so here's what we're gonna do to test out our claw. The idea is that we wanna try to pick up each of our five objects and move it from one side of our space to the other. But along the way, we're gonna figure out how well our claw is grasping and lifting and moving those objects. So I'm gonna use some of my tape. You can mark this off if you want to. You don't have to, you can just think about it and make sure you know where things are going. And I'm gonna make two sort of categories or buckets over here on the other side of my space. So I'm gonna make one space where if things are really easy to move, I'm gonna put them up here in this box. If they're a little harder to move, I'm gonna move them down here. So now we are going to try to grasp a couple of our objects. We're gonna do a few together and then you're going to do more on your own. So I'm gonna start here with my roll of tape. Now I'm starting with the roll of tape because I have a feeling it's gonna be pretty easy, right? Because I can just put two arms of my claw right through the hole of my tape. And if I'm trying to move that around, I can squeeze it and hold it. I could probably even hold it without even squeezing it. Right, that's pretty easy. I'm gonna put that in my easy category. Now I'm gonna try to grip the umbrella and see how that goes. Oh my goodness, I can barely get it. I can barely grab it. It's a little heavy. It's kind of bending my pieces a little bit. I can almost get it, but I'm kind of gonna have to just drag it and push it over here. That's definitely in the hard category. All right, I'm gonna try one more maybe this ball. Oh, almost, I almost got the ball. Let's try it again. It seems like it should fit, but the ball is really slippery and my claw doesn't have anything really great to grab it. So if I get it exactly right, I can move it over here, but I'm gonna put that in the hard spot too. So now that you see a little bit about how we're going to move and sort things, it's your job to test your adaptation claw to make sure that you can move your objects. So you can grab at least five objects. You want to make sure you have five. If you want to test more, absolutely go for it. But what you're going to do now is pause the video and go test all of your objects and sort them into whether they're easy to move or hard to move. If you want to make these two boxes, you can, or just two different areas of your space, that's fine. And you're going to go and test all five of your objects. You might want to test them a couple times if you want. If you want to test extras, that's fine. And once you're done testing and sorting, you're going to come right back to the video and we'll learn some ways to make our adaptation claw even cooler.
Hello and welcome back to STEM Camp. My name is Amy, one of your VEX Camp counselors. And previously in this session with Audra, you learned how to build the Adaptation Claw, and then you tested it out on some objects to see which ones were easy to move with the claw and which ones were a little bit more difficult, and you sorted them out just like I have here. So what we're gonna do in this session is we're going to engineer an adaptation for our claw with our VEX GO kits to make it easier to pick up and move one of our more difficult objects. And at the end of the session, we're gonna play a really fun game with the claw. So we have a lot to do, so I'm gonna get started here. So what I'm going to do is give you three examples of adaptation ideas that I've tried for the objects that I have here. Now you have slightly different objects, I'm sure. So you may wanna use one of my ideas, or you may want to take my idea and change it a little bit to match the object that you're trying to move with the claw. Because as we're engineering our adaptation, we need to do it for a specific object. Because the thing that we build to make it easier to move the umbrella is not gonna be the same thing that we want to build to move the ball. All right, so let's get started and I'll show you three different ideas that you might use to adapt your claw. So let's start with the ball. The ball is pretty difficult to move because it's slippery, and when I try to pick it up, it gets away from me really easily. The ball surface is very smooth and slippery, and also the surface of these beams on the claw are also very slippery. And that's what we're thinking about here when we're designing. Because of the slippery surfaces, we don't have much friction to help the claw grasp the ball. Friction is a force between two surfaces that prevents the surfaces from sliding or slipping. And we're going to need to make an adaptation that adds some friction. So I have an idea for that. What I'm gonna do is get out, and you can follow along with me as you go, as always, get out this particular jewel case. This is the one with the rubber bands, et cetera, in it. But I'm gonna pull out of this jewel case these two round rubber pulley wheels or pulley tires. And let me put my other pieces back so I don't lose anything. And I'm going to build something so that these two rubber tires are on the ends of my claws and they can provide some friction or some grip. So I'm gonna get two of the small red beams and I'm gonna get some standoffs. Now I have two different colors of standoffs because I've already used all of the blue ones or all of the other blue ones to build this claw. So I'm gonna have to improvise here with a couple blue and a couple yellow. And what I'm gonna do is then build a little extension to stretch these pulley wheels over onto the end of my claws and see if they grip a little bit better. So I'm gonna add two standoffs to the end of one and cap it off with a beam. See how I did that? Then I'm gonna flip it over and I'm gonna do the same thing on this side, just placing the pins into the end there, capping it off with one of these red beams. Okay, so now I have this situation where my claw has these, a little bit of extra area there on them because I want to be able to attach these somehow, these pulley wheels, but they're too hard to really stretch. So I just need to kind of wiggle them over the ends of my claw. And I'm gonna keep them towards the outside because I want them to be grippy, or towards the inside actually. See how that I have that just wrapped around there? Now I'm gonna rotate it and do it to the other side. This one's a little easier because of course I used a shorter standoff. Okay, so now I have my first adaptation. I've got some more grip or more friction here on the end. And let's now test out my blue ball and see if it's gonna make it easier to pick it up. All right. Look at that, I got it on the first try. A little bit more friction is preventing the surfaces from sliding. So I've got this first adaptation, whoops, my first adaptation that makes it easier to pick up. Okay, so that's one thing that you might try. All right, so for the second adaptation, I'm going to try to make something that makes it easier to pick up this umbrella. Now this is heavy, right? And when we were trying to move it before, we noticed that it's hard to pick up and it's actually kind of pulling the claw down. Like I can see the stress happening here. I'm afraid it's gonna actually break my claw. So we need it to be a little bit stronger. So I'm going to get out two orange connectors and two large yellow beans. And the first thing I'm going to do is just attach my orange connector to the end of each of the yellow beams, just like that, with the little bumpy side facing the beam. Same thing, twice in a row. And then I'm going to attach these to the red angle beams on my grabber to add some additional points of contact. So I'm going to put this one right there. You can see I put it right in the two middle holes of that angle beam, and then I'm going to rotate this and do the same exact thing on the other side. So now you can see, turn it back over this way, I've got a much wider claw here. There's a really good view of it. All right, now let's see if it helps us to pick up the umbrella. So I'm going to reach down. Look at that. We've got many more points of contact, and it's a lot easier to move. I don't feel like my claw is going to break. All right, so that is another adaptation that you might want to try, is adding a little bit more to your claw so your claw has more points of connection with the thing you're trying to move. All right, so for this third adaptation idea, we're going to try to make something that makes the claw a little bigger, because this stuffed toy is pretty big. And if I take my previous adaptation off and go back to the original claw, there we go, you can see that we can't really get a good grip on the stuffed animal unless I kind of hold it and squish it. So we need a wider claw. So that's going to be our next adaptation. So for this adaptation, you're going to need the jewel case of pins, two yellow beams, two orange beams, and two blue beams. And my goal here is to make this claw wider. So to do that, I'm going to start by just taking off the red angle beams that are in the original version of the claw. So I just pop those off there. My pins are still there. And I'm going to use them to now instead attach these long orange beams, because this is my idea for widening my claw so that it can more easily pick this guy up. All right, so then I'm going to need a couple of pins. I'm going to attach them here on the ends. Actually need four pins to be totally accurate. Adding them to the ends of my orange beam. Then I'm going to go ahead and add my red angle beams back on there. So you can see what I'm doing, right? It's just a much larger claw. So if I wanted to make it a little bit more curved so that it possibly is more able to pick up my guy here, I could add even another beam onto the end. So that is what I'm going to do. So two more beams and snap on the blue one. I mean, two more pins and snap on the blue beam, and then two more pins on this side to snap on the blue beam on this side. Okay, here we go. Ta-da! All right, I've got a much bigger claw here. Let's test it out on our little blue stuffy. Okay, so I can grab him, and can I pick it up? I can. Do you see what's happening? It's kind of twisting. So it's bigger. And it kind of works, but you know what I'm noticing? There's a lot of flopping in here, and these claw pieces are not rigid. Remember when we built our tower and we talked about rigidity and how rigidity is the ability to come, like, not be so bendy, basically. But these are bendy. As I move my claw, each side of the claw is bending a lot. So maybe if I make this more rigid, it'll be better. And I think one way to do that might be to change the size of this beam on the end, right? So this is really long, and it makes it able to grip something that is pretty big. Oh, that works better if I do it towards the bottom. So that's a thought too. So that's one advantage to this. But because it's long, it's not rigid and it's not very strong. So let's think about this. When you're making your adaptation, you might want to do something like this. And then you might find that you want it to be a little bit stronger. And you could try shortening, making a shorter beam onto the ends of your claw. And let's see if that actually makes my claw a little bit stronger when it grips the stuffy. All right, here we go. Changed it out. Yep, do you see how it's not twisting now? It feels much better. I don't feel like I'm gonna drop it. And it's not bending as I pick it up. Awesome. So there's a third idea for an adaptation that you might want to try. So you've seen three different ideas for adaptations that you might try. So your job now is to choose one of your objects and create your own adaptation using the pieces in your kit and try to move it and then keep improving on it until it is easier to move your chosen object. Go ahead and pause the video and create your adaptation now. You can even create more than one if you want. If you want to do it for multiple objects, that's great. And then when you're done, come on back here to the video and we'll play a fun game using your claw. Before I explain how to play the Speed Stacker Challenge, I'm going to share something with you that you're going to need to do to get ready for the next Go Camp session. And that is charge your battery. You're gonna need to get the battery out of your kit. You can tell it's the battery because it has this orange cord coming out of it and it's got a little button on the side. And it has a little receptacle here where you're going to plug in a USB cord. So you're gonna charge it just like you would charge a phone. Plug it in here and plug it into the wall. Now, you can test to see how much charge your battery has by pressing this little button here. So you can see as I press it, it's turning red, or one red light is lighting up. That's telling me that this battery needs to be charged. If I have one green light, it's gonna tell me it's partially charged. And if I have two green lights, it's going to tell me it's fully charged. Now, to test the battery charge, you can't be charging actively at that time. So you need to unplug it and then push the button to test your charge out. So go ahead and, not right now, but when you're done with this session, you're gonna need to plug in this battery to be prepared for the next session. So we are ready to play the Speed Stacker Challenge with our Adaptation Claw. I know that Audra mentioned that in the real world, there are applications for a claw like this, right? If you are a person with limited mobility and you're in a wheelchair, for example, and you need to reach something that's above your head, you can get something like this to help you out. Let's take a quick look at those before we get started with our game. So here's one example of one type of one of these grabbers. There are many variations on it with many adaptations, just like you did when you were working on your claws. You can see this one has a sort of rubber and ridged adaptation down here so that it can have a little bit of friction when it's grabbing objects. I've also seen grabbers that have magnets on the end, so you could easily pick up something that's magnetic, like your keys or something, if you drop them. And here's one being used by somebody who probably uses it every day. All right, so for that reason, we are going to do the Speed Stacker Challenge from a seated position. So what you're going to do is sit down at your table or your desk or wherever you're working. You're going to get your 10 cups out that you have ready, and you're going to place them on one side of your desk. All right, they don't have to be in any particular order, just on one side of your desk. Now, the object of this game is to pick up all of your cups, move them to the opposite side of your table or your workspace, and stack them up. So you might wanna try to time yourself and then work on improving your speed. So you would need a stopwatch or a stopwatch app or a clock for that if you decide to do that. Or maybe you just wanna go ahead and play with it and see how quickly you can do it. It's up to you. But here's what you're gonna do. You're gonna take your adaptation claw and you're gonna pick up each one of these, pretty challenging, each one of these cups. Move it to the other side, and you're going to stack them up. So there are 10 cups, so it's possible to stack them in a pyramid if you would like. So with four at the bottom, then three, then two, then one. I'm not gonna stack all of them, you get the idea. So your job is to quickly move them, to move them as quickly as possible from one side to the other and stack them up nicely. You can't use your hands, it's really tempting. I wanted to just push mine closer, but you can only use the claw. Now, you learned all about making adaptations for the claw. So when you're doing this, you might wanna think about is there an adaptation that will make it easier for me to stack the cups more quickly or easier for you to stack the cups more quickly? For me, I went back to the original claw design because I tested it out. And for the particular kind of disposable cup that I have, it was really easy just to use it as is. But your cups might not look like mine. They might be bigger or smaller. Their surface might be slippier. So you can decide if you want to use one of the adaptations you tried earlier on the cups, or you want to make something specific to make the speed stacker challenge more easy. So now it's time for you to go and try out the Speed Stacker Challenge. Have a great time doing it. Don't forget to charge that battery, and we'll see you in the next STEM Camp session really soon.